Hello and welcome to Custom Reports and Project Explorer. My name is Russ Nicloy, Civil Solutions Specialist at Macer Technologies. In this course, we are looking at Project Explorer for Civil 3D, which is an environment that allows you to analyze objects in your design file. This session is part one of three using Project Explorer for reports. Currently, we are looking at how to create custom reports and tables in Project Explorer. In this learning path, we are starting out by looking at when you should decide to use Project Explorer for creating reports or tables. First, we will look at the benefits of the report formatting in Project Explorer. Next, the benefits for Civil 3D table formats. And finally, the benefits for AutoCAD table formats. Project Explorer offers more formatting and style options than the Civil 3D reports do. Generally, if I go in and take a look at the reports from Civil 3D, we don't have a lot of options for running here, just which ones we're going to run. You end up with a report that looks like this. Now, you could change things like the header information or the amount of precision to the column data. That's all in the settings for the reports here. But you would have to go to edit the toolbox content here to get into where the format for this report is stored, and you, like I said, you would have to know some coding to get that accomplished. And basically, a report that looks like this from Civil 3D Reports could look something like this or something like this, depending on the information that you wanted to show and the standardized format that you're trying to accomplish. Now, in regards to Civil 3D tables, the differences may be small, but there are some that could be important to customers or end users. I'm going to go and take a look at the Civil 3D curve table tool. And I have a style created here for the type of report that I want to create. And I'll drop that report in here. I'll put it next to one from Project Explorer. Now, things like the first column, I can't get rid of the first column here, and I can't put the name of the alignment in the header for that table. Small things that you might be able to get around or explain away, but in this format, the Civil 3D Project Explorer format, you can accomplish that. Also, things like the distance in this table is not the same distance that we need for the information in this table. Now, it's true that you can create expressions and you could come up with the correct distance, but that's after you've created the expression and used that. These tables are much easier to create that for and much more direct about it. And finally, there is the AutoCAD table. Inside the Annotate tab, Tables, if I go to Table, basically there isn't a lot of Civil 3D object access here. We get a lot of looking at this is what the data table is going to look like. They're empty data cells that we have to fill in. Now, we could use insert fields to insert data in here, but it's going to be much more linked up to the AutoCAD objects rather than the Civil 3D objects. It is true, of course, that you could use a spreadsheet. I'm copying information from that spreadsheet, and then I'm going to paste it into this file. It's nice that I can paste a link from a spreadsheet into this file, but this is really just a linked image back to that spreadsheet. Changes to the spreadsheet will update here, but that means that I have to maintain two different files, one of them outside of Civil 3D, and the data about the project is not dynamic into this table. It's all done in the spreadsheet. In the Project Explorer spreadsheet, this data can all be dynamic if I choose it to be. And it can be done all within the Civil 3D file that I'm using the table in.